I know that you're playing Vandal Savage here, and Vandal Savage was also a role that you played in the Justice League series. And how would you say that Vandal Savage has evolved since that time? And how do you approach playing a character who's so lacking in humanity.
Yeah, there's no moral compass.
Yeah, no moral compass at all. It's just
the needle is off the charts. Interesting you should use the word evolve, because he's an immortal.
How does an immortal evolve, really? It's a one-off.
Vandal doesn't see himself as evil. Vandal sees himself as necessary. Vandal sees humankind and the world as a bit of a pestilence, and he's the exterminator. And then he will remake the world in his own image, because it is flawed and he is not. He has a healthy ego. I have a healthy ego. So I draw on my own ego to play this elite bourgeois villain. I also rely on my own kind of Renaissance nature, my interest in all things in life, art, music, poetry, history, and that's what Vandal Savage actually embodies. The artistic, poetic part of ourselves turned bad, turned evil. And what he is operatic. Opera has the most expansive villains and heroes in our entertainment parlance, you know what I'm saying? And in our myths, in our mythic living, we need those kinds of characters for heroes to butt up against. And Vandal has that size.
Would you say that he is a more archetypal character than he just seems to be the very root of that.
Yes, he is. He is. But he's a bit of a smooth criminal, you know. So that he's got a lot of lyricism to him. In this version of Vandal, he's less that way than I played him in the Justice League series, because I really believe that Vandal feels he's got the key. And when you feel like you have the key and it's a sure thing, you don't sugarcoat it. You don't have to nuance it, because you got the answer. And that's what he feels he has in this particular movie. So it changes him from before, where he's kind of trying to take over the world. Right now, he knows he can do it. And that makes him more evil and straight no chaser.
So now contrast this with John Jones, the role that you played in Smallville. They both have an inner strength.
Yes.
They both do great things. In Vandal's case, not necessarily good things, but still great.
Right.
So it seems to me that there's still that well of strength to draw from for defining the character.
Well, it's like the yin and yang, isn't it? I mean, in Asian philosophy, you have yin, you have yang. Without the light, there's no darkness. Without the darkness, there's no light. So you're talking about two sides of the same coin. You know, Vandal is the yang of it. He's the darkness. John Jones is the yin. And because of his understanding of both Martian nature and human nature, he can contrast the compassion that he feels against an evil like a Vandal Savage or a dark side or a, you know, fill in the blank. For me, to play those two characters is not very different. The difference is that I believe evil and difficulty and darkness is a lot easier for humans to fight than to be happy and joyous and love it for some weird reason. But Vandal plays that darkness and he relishes it. John definitely wants to shine a light on the world. And that's the difference in the two characters.
So you mentioned that you, in another interview, that you have a broad exposure to the humanities yourself, that you appreciate the arts and sciences. And you mentioned about that you enjoy drawing, is that?
Oh, yeah.
That's something probably most people don't know about.
I have some pretty interesting drawings that people would like to see. I mean, I do a lot of superhero drawings, you know. A lot of it is rendering from other people's work, which I really like. But I love the human form. I love the human dynamic form, which is what superhero drawing is all about. And I was an art student, so I bring that to my education as an artist. And so reading comic books helped me with many things, to read, to visualize, to imagine, to draw. And all of that comes into play as an artist, full stop, whether you're a painter, singer, or an actor, which is what my chosen expression is.
So I am speaking to a true Renaissance man. Phil Morris, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you.